Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to today's broadcast of the Boston College baseball team. Today we have the Boston College Eagles taking on the Northeastern Huskies in what is to be an interstate matchup and a very good matchup of two winning baseball teams. I am your announcer for today, Gregory Mihalik, and let's take a look at these two teams as we get going here in the pregame with about 14 minutes before the first pitch. BC right now is 11-7. They've won four of their last five since a weekend sweep by North Carolina State, about two weekends back now. And they've so far only done two home games this year, but they are 2-0 in those home games, and they've won by a combined score of 37-11, with both games ending by the seventh inning because of the mercy rule. And in all of that, they've had five starters who have played all 18 games. So let's look at a couple of them. Those are my key players for the BC Eagles today. You have Nick Wang, who has started all 18 games with a batting average of .351 and an on-base of .429. He has 9 home runs and 26 RBIs on the season, and he will be batting second in the DH spot today. So he will be a player to look out for as one of the power bats for this BC team. And number two for the Eagles, we'll look at Vince Kamini, who has also started all 18 games. He has a .338 batting average with a .458 on base percentage. He has 4 home runs and 22 RBIs as well, and he will be batting in the third spot today, playing second base. So this Eagles team, they've got a pretty good offense going for them. The lowest on-base percentage of any of their starters is .291. And of their last six games, four of them they have scored more than 10 runs. The issue is their pitching hasn't been that great, as proposed by their starter, Evan Moore, today, who has 6 appearances, 7 innings pitched with a .771 ERA. He has not started a game yet this year, so this will be start number one for him. But the Eagles are looking to see if they can get what they had against Merrimack, which was sort of, in a way, it was like positional pitching, where whenever they needed a guy, or decisive pitching, whenever they needed a guy in a certain situation, they were able to get a zero on the scoreboard, and that's what kind of helped them against Merrimack, if you'll remember, last Tuesday. Speaking before that, actually, they won their weekend series against Pittsburgh, for those of you that haven't been watching. They took 2 out of 3 from Pittsburgh this weekend at Pittsburgh, and they're a winning baseball team, too, so it was a good series for BC. But last Tuesday, when they played Merrimack, their first, essentially their home opener for the season, their starter gave up 2 runs in the first inning, but they were able to bounce back, get 3 runs in the bottom of the frame, and put 3 consecutive zeros on the board with help from their reliever Gavin Hash, who put 2 scoreless on the board. So getting those situational pitching moments, if they can get a couple of zeros on the scoreboard, that should help, especially against this Northeastern Husky offense, which is 12. Their team is 12-5 on the whole, and they've won 6 of their last 7. Of course, most of those wins have come against teams lower than .500. Last couple against Rhode Island, who right now is 3-10 on the year, and of course Bryant University as well, who is 5-9 at this point. However, all 5 losses for them this season have been on the road, so this does bode well for BC, who is starting up their home stretches. They have a home series coming up this weekend against a mighty Virginia Tech team. But for Northeastern, 5 of their wins recently have seen them score 10 or more runs as well, so they also have a very potent offense. And in all 7 of their last few games, of which they've won 6, their opponents have scored less than 10 runs, so their pitching has been holding opposing offenses. Of course, it'll remain to be seen whether or not BC's offense can break that streak. And the key players, meanwhile, for Northeastern are guys like Tyler McGregor, their first baseman, who will be batting second as well today. He has a batting average of .371 with a .452 on base percentage, and he has started all games for the Huskies. And then my second player for them is Alex Lane, who will be DHing for them in the cleanup spot, in the fourth spot in the batting order. He has a .455 batting average with a .405 on base percentage and leads the team with 6 home runs and 30 RBIs. So he will be a power bat to watch in that cleanup spot. So we'll see which side wins here. We've got 2 very good offenses coming up against each other. Alrighty. So let's get to the lineups real quick before we take our break before first pitch. So the lineup for the Northeastern Huskies. Starting off, or leading off, I should say, and playing second base, number 19, the senior Luke Beckstein. Batting second, the first baseman, a senior, number 33, Tyler McGregor. Batting third in center field, the junior, number 8, Mike Sirota. Batting in the cleanup spot, as I said, and DHing today, a senior, number 10, Alex Lane. In the 5 hole, we have a sophomore playing third base, number 5, Jack Goodman. At 6, in right field, we have the junior, number 21, Justin Bosland. In the 7 hole, the sophomore playing left field, Harrison Feinberg, number 9. Batting 8th and catching, a senior number 49, Gregory Bazo. And in the 9th and last spot in the order, a sophomore playing shortstop number 28, Carmelo Musasha. And starting for Northeastern today is a right-handed pitcher, Michael Gemma, a senior, number 31. He is 2-0 this season with 1 start and 4 appearances. He has pitched 8 innings, 4 hits, and no earned runs allowed. 7 walks to 9 strikeouts for him with a 174 batting average against. So he seems to be a formidable pitcher on the stat sheet, but we'll see what we'll see what the Eagles offense can bring. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, leading off and playing center field, number 11, the senior Cameron Leary. Batting second and DHing, number 44, the junior Nick Wang. Batting third and playing second base, a senior Vince Camini, number 14. Batting cleanup, the first baseman, a sophomore, number 18, Kyle Wolf. Batting fifth and playing third base, the senior, number 7, Patrick Roche. Batting sixth today in left field, a freshman, number 2, Adam Magpok. In the 7th spot, we have the senior playing right field, number 5, Cam Karaher. Batting 8th and catching is the senior, number 23, Parker Landwehr. And batting 9th, the junior Sam McNulty, number 28, playing shortstop. And as I said, starting for the Eagles today is a senior, Evan Moore, number 36. He's a right-handed pitcher who has 6 appearances. As I said, this is also his first start. He's pitched in 7 innings, giving up a 7.71 ERA with 9 hits and 6 earned runs over that stretch. He has 4 walks and 3 strikeouts to his name. And he has given up a 3.46 batting average against so far in those 7 innings. So we'll see if he can get a bounce-back performance here today in his first start. And all righty, ladies and gentlemen, I will flip the camera around now so you can get a look at the field before we hit start time. We have not done the national anthem yet. That should be coming up very soon. And after the national anthem, I will come back and we will get going towards the first pitch.
first for the visitors from Northeastern. Leading off, the second baseman, number 19, Luke Beckstein. Batting second, the first baseman, number 33, Tyler McGregor. Batting third, the center fielder, number 8, Mike Sirota. Batting cleanup, the designated hitter, number 10, Alex Lane. Batting fifth, the third baseman, number 5, Jack Goodman. Batting sixth, the right fielder, number 21, Justin Boswell. Batting seventh, the left fielder, number 9, Harrison Feinberg. Batting eighth, the catcher, number 49, Gregory Boswell. Batting ninth, the shortstop, number 28, Carmelo Piscacci. And pitching for the Huskies, number 31, Michael Gemma. The Huskies are coached by Mike Levine. He's assisted by Kevin Cobb, Fred Mulberg, and Chris Foster. And now, the starting lineup for your Boston College Eagles. Leading off for BC, the center fielder, number 11, Cameron Leary. Batting second, the designated hitter, number 44, Nick Wang. Batting third, the second baseman, number 14, Vince Cimini. Batting cleanup, the first baseman, number 18, Kyle Wolf. Batting fifth, the third baseman, number 7, Patrick Boat. Batting sixth, the left fielder, number 2, Adam Nadler. Batting seventh, the right fielder, number 5, Dan Garrett. Batting eighth, the captain, number 23, Parker Landry. Batting ninth, the shortstop, number 28, Sam Nelson. And pitching for the Eagles, number 36, Evan Moore. The Eagles are coached by Todd Antonelli. He's assisted by Bryce Sullivan, Ryan Forrest, and Dan Fisher. The umpires today include Tim Rosso, Connor Hogan, Dave Martinez, and Derek. We, the ACC, are committed to seeing each other as equals and treating others with respect and dignity at all times, recognizing that our differences don't divide us, but they make us stronger. The NCAA, ACC, and Boston College promote good support for children, our student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request the cooperation and supporting the participants and victims of Boston College. Profanity, racial, excessive comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated in the law, or even possible. Also, the consumption and possession of alcoholic beverages and tobacco products is prohibited. Thank you.
Alrighty, folks. Now, as we see, we have the mound meeting going on, or the plate meeting, I should say, between the umpires and the two head coaches of the teams. For Northeastern, it is Tom Glavine as their head coach, and for BC, in his first year, is Todd Interdonato. Temperatures at game time sitting right about the mid to high 40s. Wind looks like there's a slight breeze blown straight out to center field. And it's a little bit cloudy today, but I still patches a blue sky, so we could see the sun occasionally every now and then, but for now it's a little overcast on the field. BC getting ready to take the field. And as was said earlier by the announcers, the umpires for today, the home plate umpire, Tim Rosso. The first base umpire today is Connor Hoagland. Second base umpire, Dave Martinez. And at third base, you'll see Jerry Martinez. All righty. So as we get going here, folks, again, I'll give you what the field looks like for BC again today. Catching, we have Parker Landwehr. Pitching, of course, is Evan Moore. At first base is Kyle Wolf. Second base is Vince Kamini. Third base, you've got Patrick Roche. At shortstop, you have Sam McNulty. In left field, you have Adam Magpak. Center field is Cameron Leary. And in right field is Cam Carraher. First up for Northeastern today will be Luke Beckstein, their second baseman, number 19. He has a .340 average on the year. He started 15 of Northeastern's games this year. He has no home runs. He has 7 RBIs and 3 doubles to his name. And he has an on-base percentage that's right around 500, that's a little over 500 actually. They've got two guys on their roster that have on-base percentages over 500. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Game time starting around 3:05 today. With the first pitch from Evan Moore upcoming. And here it is. Ball one taken upstairs. Again, as we get going here, this is Evan Moore's first start of the season. And a called strike there in the outside corner. 1-1 count to start the at-bat. Here's the next pitch. Misses high and out, it looks like. And the count's 2-1. Sun looks like it's trying to shine through here. Here's the next pitch. Taken for strike two. Almost offered at that, almost thought of swinging around at that one, but he held up and it was called a strike. 2-2 the count now. And here's the next pitch. Ball misses low and in. Full count to the leadoff batter. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Nobody on and no outs to start the game. Here's the payoff pitch. Popped up on the infield, it looks like. First baseman underneath it. Second baseman calls him off and makes the catch, and that'll be the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up number 33, Tyler McGregor. Again, he's got a .371 batting average on the year. He's one of their better hitters. And he takes a called strike. 0-1 to start the count. And here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. 1-1. Here's the next pitch. Strike two called. He almost swung at that one, but the umpire called it. 1-2 the count now. And here's the 1-2. Grounded right. It jumps off the first baseman. Can he get it in time? He does! Got him on the out. First base coach is saying that they want a replay. Or they want a review, I should say. And it looks like the umpires are going to come together. It was a shot of a line drive that took a one hop off that first baseman. Ricocheted a little to his right. First baseman was able to corral it enough. And they're going to go review it. It's a very close play from up here in the booth. It's hard to tell, but the umpire looked like he was right on it. Made a bang-bang call there. We'll see. We'll see what they do in the review. If the call stands, it'll be nobody on with 2 outs in the first inning. Or if it's overturned and he's called safe, it'll be a man on first with 1 away for the number 3 hole hitter, Mike Sirota. You'll see Evan Moore taking some practice pitches while he can. Umpires look like they're coming back from their review. They'll be reviewing plays down behind the Northeastern dugout today on the first base side. And they overturn the call, so the runner is safe at first base on what looked to be from here a bang-bang call. So there'll be a man on first with one away now. For, as I said, the number three hole hitter, Mike Sirota, who has a .275 average on the year. He has also started in all 17 games for the Huskies this year. He has a .405 on base percentage as well. Here's the first pitch. Strike one called. So an 0-1 count. Again, one away, runner on first now. Pickoff attempt made. Runner got back safely. They ruled that hit for Northeastern an infield single as well. There's a line drive into the gap. It looks like it may drop. Let's see. No, nice play by the center fielder to get the ball there. Nice running catch on the move into the gap. It's pretty deep, about 5 feet off the warning track it looked like, 5 or 10 feet. But that'll be out number two. And that'll bring up the cleanup hitter, number 10, Alex Lane, DHing today. So he has a man on first with two outs now. Pickoff attempt to first. He'll get back safely. And here's the first pitch. Nope, pickoff attempt instead. Runner got back safe again. So here's the first pitch. Ball misses inside. 1-0 to start the count. And here's the 1-0. Ball misses high and out. 2-0. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Ball misses high. 3-0 the count now. Again, two outs and a man on first base. And here's the 3-0 pitch. Strike one called right on that inside part of the plate. Count moves to 3-1. And the next offering. Ball four misses low. So Alex Lane will take a walk. And that'll bring up the number five hitter, also number five on his jersey, Jack Goodman. He's a .321 batting average. He started in 13 games this year for the Huskies. He has a .383 on base percentage. So there's men on first and second with two away now. Strike one called. 0-1 to start the count here. Evan Moore looking for a clean inning in his first start. Strike two called. Owen 2 the count now to the hitter. Here's the next pitch. Ball taken low. 1-2 the count. See if Evan Moore can get the strikeout that he needs here. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Strike three. And he gets the strikeout needed and gets out of the first inning. So as we hit the middle of the first inning, Huskies get an infield single, but are held, infield single and a walk, I should say, but are held to just that. No runs on the board. We move to the bottom of the first inning. BC's lineup coming up for their first time today, and we'll be back. All right, as we get going here in the bottom of the first inning, number 11, Cameron Leary, will be coming up first. And again, the starting pitcher for Northeastern today is Michael Gemma. This is his second start and fifth appearance of the season. He has not yet allowed a run, so he has a zero ERA and eight innings pitched so far this year. So we'll see what Leary can do here, the first pitch. Ball misses high. So a 1-0 count to start the at-bat here. And here comes the next pitch. Fly ball deep into that right center field gap again. Center fielder looks to be underneath it, and he's got it on the warning track for out number one. One away here in the early going of the bottom of the first. And the batter is Nick Wang, number 44, and DHing today. Both Leary and Wang have started all 18 games for the Eagles this year. In fact, the first four players on this batting lineup have started all 18 games for the Eagles. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses just high. One-oh to start the count again. Next pitch, called strike one. As I said, Wang has a .351 batting average coming into it this season with 9 home runs. Here's the 1-1. Ball misses outside. 2-1 the count now to Wang. And here comes the 2-1. Strike two call. And here's the 2-2. Strike three called. Rung him up on that outside edge. And that'll be out number two. So they'll bring up Vince Cimini. Batting third and playing second base today. He started also all 18 games with a .338 batting average and four home runs. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses upstairs. So again, two quick outs for the Eagles here. Nobody on. And here's the 1-0. Strike one called. 1-1 the count now. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Strike two called. Gemma's throwing strikes early, it seems. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss, strike three, and Samini down on strikes. Back-to-back Ks for Gemma at the bottom of the first inning. We'll move to the top of the second. No score in this Eagles-Huskies game. We'll be right back. Alrighty, time now for the top of the second inning. Evan Moore still out there for the Eagles. He had a walk and a strikeout last time out. Let's see what he can do in this second inning of work here as he faces the number five hitter, number five, Jack Goodman, who has a .321 batting average on the year and takes a strike one on the first pitch. Excuse me, he faces number 21, batting sixth. Apologize for that. Number 21, Justin Bosland. He started 12 games with a .341 average, and there is a strikeout for the Eagles. One away here now. Number two strikeout so far for Evan Moore. And up comes number nine, Harrison Feinberg, batting seventh in the order. He has a .220 batting average on the year as he takes ball one upstairs. So 1-0 count to start it here. There's a fly ball. First baseman and catcher tracking it down the foul line. Might have a play, and he does. Nice catch down right next to the Northeastern dugout there, and it'll be two away.
Now batting for the Huskies, number 49, Gregory Bozzo.
So that'll bring up in the eighth spot, number 49, Gregory Bozzo, who's batting .156 on the year. He has started 10 games for the Huskies, and here's the first pitch to him. Ball taken low and outside. So 1-0 count, two away here with nobody on for the Huskies. Strike one called. 1-1 count to Bazo. And here's the next pitch. Ground ball. Shortstop makes a nice stop. Can he get the ball there in time? He does not. Throw was late coming out, but the shortstop made a nice play to keep it on the infield there. Nice diving stop to his right into the hole between third and the short. But now there's a man on first with two outs. And that'll bring up the nine-hole hitter, Carmelo Musasha. The shortstop batting .214 on the year in 14 starts. And here's the first pitch. Strike one called. ..01 count to start the at-bat here. Again, man on first with two away. No score here in the top of the second inning. Pickoff attempt. But the runner gets back safe. There comes the 0-1. Ball hits the dirt. 1-1 the count now. And here comes the next pitch. Fouled off the batter. 1-2 the count now. And here comes the 1-2. Ball hits the dirt again. Runner at first thought of moving, but he shows against it. Catcher made a nice stop there to keep the ball in front of him. And the count moves to 2-2. Here's the next pitch. Did he go? He went around, says the first base umpire, and that'll be strike three. So that's the third strikeout on the day for Evan Moore. He gets through another clean inning, gives up another hit. But still no score on the board as we move to the bottom of the second inning. And we'll be back right after this. And here we go in the bottom of the second inning here. Michael Gemma again coming back out for his second inning of work. He had back-to-back strikeouts to end the bottom of the first inning. And batting to face him will be the cleanup hitter, Kyle Wolf, number 18. He has a .329 batting average on the year. He has started all 18 games for the Eagles. And he'll take strike one. 0-1 to start the count here. And here comes the next pitch. Strike two called. So 0-2 the count now. Let's see if Wolf can put something in play. He fouls that one away into the netting. Count holds at 0-2. Here comes the next pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Strikeout number three for Gemma. And that'll be one away here in the second inning. And here comes the number five hitter, Patrick Roche, number seven. Again, one away here in the bottom of the second inning. And here comes the first pitch. Strike one called again. Oh and one to start the count here. Here's the next pitch. Strike two. Gemma working very efficiently up there. As both counts now in this inning have gone to 0-2 so far. There's the next offering. Ball misses high and out. 1-2 the count now. And here's the next pitch. Ball misses well outside. Count goes to 2-2. And here's the 2-2. Ground ball. Second baseman is able to get it. Fires quickly. And the umpire got him out. Yeah, the umpire says he's out. So that'll be out number two in the inning, and that'll bring up the number six hitter, Adam Magpak. He has started 9 games for the Eagles this year so far, and he has a .206 batting average. So with two outs and nobody on, he shows bunt. Pulls back and takes strike one. .01 to start the count. Ball that one misses low and out. 1-1 now. And here's the next pitch. Swing and a miss, strike two. 1-2 the count. There's the 1-2. Ball misses outside. Count goes to 2-2. And here's the next pitch. Another swing and a miss for strike three. That's 4 strikeouts so far for Gemma. And that'll end the bottom of the second inning here as we move into the third frame. Gemma, another 2 strikeouts in the inning. No score yet. Northeastern beating the Eagles in the hit column 2-0. But no runs scored yet as we head to the top of the third inning. And we'll be back right after this short break. And here we go into the top of the third inning here. It's been a pitcher's duel so far, it seems, through these first two frames. No runs scored, only two hits on the board, both of them by Northeastern. And seven combined strikeouts so far. As the batting order turns over for Northeastern, strike one called. And we'll see Luke Beckstein back up. He's 0 for 1 so far today. He popped up in the first inning. It's a ball that misses high and out. 1-1 the count now here in the leadoff hitter of the third inning. And here's the next pitch. Ball misses low, 2-1. Next offering. Bent him at the knees, and that got him for strike two. Two and two the count now. And here's the next pitch. Miss is outside, just off the corner. Full count now, 3-2. Here's the next pitch. Line drive, but foul. Outside the right field fence. And the count holds at 3-2. Here's the next pitch. Swing and a miss, strike three. And that'll be strikeout number four for Evan Moore. One away here in the top of the third inning. And that'll bring up number 33, Tyler McGregor. He had an infield single in the first inning. And he takes a ball to start off. 1-0 the count. Here's the next pitch. Strike one called on that lower part of the zone. And the count now 1-1. Ground ball right to the second baseman. Fields it cleanly. Throw to first. Gets him. Two gone here now in the top of the third inning.
Now batting for the Huskies, number 8, Mike Sirota.
So that'll bring up the number 3 hitter, I should say. Number 8, Mike Sirota. The first pitch, ball misses low. 1-0 to start here. The 1-0, swing and a miss for strike one. One and one the count now. And here's the next offering. Line drive into the gap in left center field, and that's going to land. It's going to roll up against the wall. Center fielder makes a good play on it, and the runner will hold at second. So a two-out double for Mike Sirota, and that'll bring up the cleanup hitter. Number 10, Alex Lane. So man on second now with two away. Ooh. Almost got him to swing, but it was low in the zone. Called for a ball. 1-0 to start the count here. Next pitch, strike one called. 1-1 the count now. There's the 1-1. Swing and a miss for strike two. It'll bring the count to 1-2 here. Again, two away. Man on second in the top of the third inning. Still no score in this game. Looks like time was called. See if Evan Moore can put this batter away. But three clean innings. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses outside. Count goes to 2-2. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. Full count. Three balls, two strikes. And here's the payoff pitch. Ball misses high. That'll walk him. Puts men on first and second. And it'll bring up the five hitter, number five, Jack Goodman, who had a strikeout back in the first inning. It looks like the coach is going to come out and have a word with his starter. Alrighty, and as we get started back up here, again, men on first and second, two away here in the top of the third inning. Evan Moore trying to get three scoreless innings on the board here as we get strike one called to start off the at-bat against number five, Jack Goodman. Again, he struck out back in the first inning. Here's the 0-1. Ball misses low. Catcher kept it in front of him, though. Runners will hold. Count moves to 1-1. He steps off the mound. And here's the 1-1. Ball misses out. 2-1 the count now. There's the next pitch. Strike two called. Right on that outside edge again. Two balls, two strikes the count now. The Eagles could really use an out here. Get them out of only their second position with runners in scoring position against them for Northeastern. There's a ground ball down the line, and it goes foul. Third baseman was charging up against it to see if it came back, but it stayed on the left side of that foul line down the third baseline. And the count holds at 2-2. There's a grounder to the third baseman, and he'll take it to the bag, and that'll be out number three. So that'll end the top of the third inning here. One hit and a walk for Northeastern again, but still no score on the board as we head to the bottom of the third inning. We'll take a short break and be back after this. And here we go in the bottom of the third inning. Number five, Cam Carraher, coming up here. Eagles now in the bottom third of their lineup here, 7-8-9 coming up. Carraher started 17 of the Eagles' 18 games. Pitch high and in. He's a 290 batting average with a 444 on base percentage. He has a 1-0 count to start here in the bottom of the third. That pitch misses high and out as well. 2-0 to start here. Michael Gemma back on the mound. Has 4 strikeouts today. Hasn't allowed a hit yet. 2-0 here on the leadoff batter, though. That pitch misses out. 3-0. Three balls, no strikes, no outs. Here's the next pitch. Ball four misses outside, so Carraher walks. And that's the first base runner today for the Eagles, as they have a man on with nobody out. So that'll bring up number 23, the catcher, Parker Landwehr, batting in the eighth spot. He's appeared in 15 games with 11 starts with a .229 batting average on the year. He's a .291 on base percentage as well. Pickoff attempt to first, no good. Infielders shading to the left of second base. First baseman the only one near on that side of the field, and a foul ball back into the netting. 0-1 to start the count. So again, runner on first, nobody out. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Ball misses high, 1-1. One and one the count now. Again, the Eagles looking for their first hit today. Just got their first base runner with a walk here in the bottom of the third. Pitch misses inside, 2-1. Here's the next pitch. Called for strike two. Two balls, two strikes the count now. Gemma set, and here's the pitch. Swing and a miss for strike three, and Landwehr goes down on strikes. That's strikeout number five for Gemma today. And that'll bring up the number nine hitter, Sam McNulty, number 28. He comes up with one out and a man on first base. Pickoff attempt made towards first. Runner got back safely. Third base coach arguing about a balk made on the pitcher. Umpires didn't call it, but he was chirping a little bit down there. Umpires made note of it. Said something to him in response. Here's the next pitch. Fly ball down the line. First baseman running to get it, but he's not able to get there. It's just out of his reach. There'll be a foul ball, 0-1 to start the count. Here's the next pitch. Grounder down into the second base hole, and that's going to be a base hit. Runners hold at first and second, but the first hit of the day for the Eagles by Sam McNulty. And that'll turn over the lineup for the Eagles now as it brings up Cameron Leary again. He flew out to center field in the first inning. But now the Eagles have a scoring threat here. They have men on first and second with one away. And here comes the first pitch. Ball misses outside, 1-0 to start the count. And time called by the catcher. Going out to speak to his pitcher. Probably try and calm them down. This is the first inning that they've had base runners on. Again, we're looking at right around a little over 30 pitches, 32 pitches by my count. With a 1-0 count to start the at-bat here. Here's the next pitch. Popped up, catcher's looking, but it'll land behind into the bleachers. One ball, one strike, the count now. Again, men on first and second with one away here in the bottom of the third inning. Still no score. Eagles just got their first hit of the day. Swing and a miss for strike two by Leary. Chased a high fastball there. Here's the 1-2. Nope. Motion's back. Now it looks like the coach is coming out to talk to the umpire. They motioned it like it was his second time coming off the mound. For those of you that don't know, they have recently changed the rules in both college and in the MLB. Now they've reduced the number of times that you can motion off of the mound. I do not know the exactly precise rules, but I think it's you get two motions off the mound before that third one incurs a penalty. If you motion off the mound and all the runners are safe, that third time the runners get a free base. Hard to tell from here what the coach was arguing about, but made a motion out to second base like he was talking about that last incident. But 2-2 the count now. Again, one away, men on first and second base. And here comes the next pitch. Strike three called against Leary. Strikeout number 6 for Gemma today. So now there's two away for number 44, Nick Wang. Two men on, two away here. He struck out back in the first inning. Let's see if he can't redeem himself here, get the Eagles on the board. is the first pitch in the at-bat. The strike one called. 0-1 the count. Here's the next pitch. Strike two called down in that outside corner again. 0-2 the count. Infielders look like they're shaded again to the right side of the left side of the diamond, I should say. Shortstop playing halfway between second and third, and that second baseman playing almost right behind the bag. Strike three called against Wang there. And that's strikeout number seven. A little bit of chirping from, can't tell if it's fans or dugout, but seventh strikeout today for Gemma. We head to the top of the fourth inning, still no score. Northeastern coming up to bat. And as we head to the top of the fourth inning here, again, no score through three innings for either team. The Eagles have switched pitchers. They've brought up number 31, Gavin Hashey, the freshman. We saw him pitch last Tuesday against Merrimack. He pitched two scoreless then. Let's see if he can't repeat that here. Bunt to the first bunted by the first batter and bunted foul. Ruled by the home plate umpire. His first up in this inning is number 21, Justin Boslin, the six hitter. He struck out back in the second inning. And 0-1 the count here. Line drive just misses the second baseman's glove, and that's going to go into right field for a single. So that'll bring up in the seven hole, number nine, Harrison Feinberg. He'll have a man on with nobody out. Hashey set. And here comes the first pitch. Strike one called. 0-1 the count now to Feinberg. Pickoff motion to first, safe. First baseman thought he might have had him. It was a very close play, but he got back. Another pickoff motion. Runner gets back to first. Again, nobody out. No balls, one strike to the batter. Fouled by the batter with the runner going. So the runner will be sent back. Two strikes now the count. Feinberg fouled out of play in the second inning. I should say he popped up in foul territory to the first baseman. He has an 0-2 count on him now. No outs, man on first. Here's the 0-2. Ball misses high. 1-2 the count now. Pickoff motion again. Runner safe. Another pickoff motion. Runner safe again, though. So I guess that's four pickoff attempts, so he must not have. The rule must not apply here, I guess. Must be misinformed. But anyways, we have a 1-2 count on the batter now. Ooh, first baseman lost control of the ball there. And the runner's going to first base, or second base, I should say, and he's going to make it. On that missed catch by the first baseman, throws a little underneath his glove. Got past the base. First base coach told the runner to go, and he will. So the runner's now on second base. Nobody out. One ball, two strikes the count. Foul ball into the backstop. Count holds at 1-2. Here comes the next pitch. Runner going to third. Swing and a miss. But he's going to be safe at third. So strike three to the batter, but the runner gets to third base. So one away here now. One away with a man on third. And it'll bring up Gregory Bazo, the eight hitter. It looks like the umpires are going to come together. BC might have asked for a review of that. Play it down to third base. And the umpires motion that they're going to review. So again, there was a swing and a miss for the strikeout in the batter's box. Meanwhile, the runner was taking off for third. Catcher made a really nice throw over, and the infielder laid a good tag, it looked like. But the umpire at third called him safe, and we'll see what the review says. So BC gets an out either way. It's just whether or not there's going to be an out over at third base, which would mean nobody on, two outs. If they declare that if they overturn the play and call that the runner was out, or if they uphold the call saying that the runner is safe, that'll mean there is now a runner on third base with one away for the eight hole hitter, excuse me. Gregory Bazo, who singled back in the second inning. Thank you. Motion the call. And the call is upheld. Runner is safe at third base. So again, that means there's now a runner on third with one away. So as I said, Gregory Bazo coming up here. He singled back in the second inning. See if Gavin Hash can get him to roll over on one here. As that ball misses in. 1-0 the count here. Infield playing inside. First baseman playing on the grass over at first base. Each of the fielders almost in line with the base paths. Ball misses, runner goes for home. And he is going to be safe as that throw was late on the wild pitch. So Northeastern gets on the board here in the top of the fourth inning. On a wild pitch by Hash. Counts now 2-0. So 2-0 the count now, nobody on with one away. Swing and a miss for strike one. So here comes the 2-1. Fly ball deep into left field. Fielder going back on it. Looking, and it is out of here for a home run. Right down that left field line. And it is a home run by Gregory Bazo, his second of the year. And Northeastern is now up 2-0 here in the top of the fourth inning. So the number 9 hitter, Carmelo Musaccia, now up here, number 28. Again, nobody on with one away. Northeastern now has 2 on the board. Ball misses low. 1-0 the count. Next pitch, line drive right to the second baseman. And that'll be out number 2.
Now batting for the Huskies, number 19.
So their order goes back to the top of the lineup. And we'll see number 19, Luke Beckstein, come up. Two outs, nobody on. He is 0-for-2 on the day with a strikeout. And Hash gets him in the shoulder. So a hit by pitch on the first pitch of the at bat sends a runner down to first base. And it'll bring up Tyler McGregor, the number 2 hole hitter. Two outs, runner on first base. Here's the first pitch. Strike one called, right down the gun. All one to start the count here. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low and out. 1-1. Second baseman playing almost into into shallow right field, it looks like. Playing a little bit of a shift, but the infielders on the shortstop and the third base side are still playing their normal positions. 1-1 the count now. Swing and a miss for strike two. Now they're showing massive shift. Third baseman playing in the shortstop spot, and shortstop playing as the pickoff attempt goes. Runner gets back safely. Shortstop playing almost where the second baseman would on a double play situation. Now he's moving more towards the first base side. He's still only about 60, maybe 40 feet off of the bag there, off of the second base bag. So a 1-2 count. Fly ball into left center field. Center fielder ranging to get it, and he could not make the catch as it hits the wall. One run is going to be in the set from first. And the runner stops at and the other runner stops at second base, so it is now 3-0 Huskies on that RBI double. The nice hit right into the gap there. Center fielder had a play on it, but looked like it just hit off the top of his glove there. And it'll bring up the three-hole hitter, number 8, Mike Sirota, who has 1-for-2 today with a double. There's a fly ball out of play. Owen won the count here. Two away, runner on second now. Looks like the third base and the home plate umpire are meeting. He handed him something that he put on the back of his belt there, but I can't see what it is clearly. Anyways, 0-1 the count now to the hitter. Two outs, man on second base. Huskies now up 3-0 here in the top of the fourth inning. Here's the next pitch. Fly ball straight up. First baseman going in for it and calling it, and he is going to make the catch, and that'll get him out of the fourth inning. But the Huskies put up 3. On 2 Eagles errors and a couple of hits. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Let's see if the Eagles can't respond. And we'll be right back after another short break. Now time for the bottom of the fourth inning. Vince Cimini leading off for the Eagles, the number 3 hitter, number 14. He struck out back in the first inning. Michael Gemma still up pitching for the Huskies. And strike one. To lead off the at-bat here. Northeastern was able to put up 3 runs in the top of the frame. Let's see if the Eagles can't respond. 1-0. And that ball misses low. 1-1 the count now. There's the next pitch. Strike two called. One ball, two strikes on Cimini here. And here's the next pitch. Ball misses low and away. 2-2 the count now. Gemma only had about 40 pitches as of right now. 7 strikeouts and a walk to his name. Here's the next pitch. Fouled into the netting behind us. Or behind the home plate, I should say. 2-2 the count. And here's the next pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. Third baseman can't get it in time. And that will be an infield single. Rolled right down the line. I don't think it hit the bag. But the third baseman couldn't corral it in. And it skipped off of his glove down into the foul territory. And it is labeled as an infield single here. And that'll bring up the cleanup hitter, Kyle Wolf, number 18, with a man on first and nobody out. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses low. 1-0. Here's the 1-0. Line drive, base hit in the right field, in the left field, I should say. Lead runner holds up at second base. Nice hit by Wolf, though. So runners again now on first and second for the Eagles. Nobody out this time. And that'll bring up the third baseman, Patrick Roche, batting in the fifth spot. And the pitching coach now coming out for Northeastern. His starter had been cruising well up until this point. But now with a couple of hits on him, it looks like the Eagles could start rallying. But Wolf had a rocket off of his bat just over the shortstop's glove by about a foot and a half or so. The umpire goes out to break up the meeting. As we said earlier, it'll bring up number 7, Patrick Roach, who grounded out in his first at bat back in the second inning. He shows bunt on the first pitch. Third baseman and first baseman creeping in, and he will lay down a bunt. Will it stay fair? No, it will not. It'll be strike one on the foul bunt attempt by Roach. Eagles might be trying to play some strategic ball here. The successful bunt could get runners to second and third with one away, put two guys in scoring position. We'll see if he shows it again. 0-1 the count now, nobody out. He's on first and second. He shows bunt again. He does lay it down. Foul call, though. By the home plate umpire, he called it foul. So that'll be strike two on the batter now. It'll most likely, it may take off the bunt attempt now. But we'll see what happens. Showing bunt again. Here comes the 0-2. No, he pulls back. And he's going to swing and fouls it away down the third baseline. Count holds at 0-2. So So that time he showed bunt at first and then pulled it away right as the pitch was coming in. Let's see if he might try it again with an 0-2 count here. No. Looks like he's going to hold in a normal batting stance here. Pickoff attempt made to second, and the second baseman almost couldn't get it. His momentum took him towards second. He had to stop his momentum and twist his body a little bit to get that throw. It was a little bit off the mark, but he was able to get it. Runner got back safely to second base. Count still 0-2. Nobody out here. And here's the next pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. Roach goes down on strikes. That's strikeout number 8 for Gemma. And it'll bring up Adam Magpak, the number 6 hitter. Now one out with men on first and second. Magpak coming into this game, he had 9 starts, appeared in 13 games. He was a 2.06 hitter with a 3.08 on base percentage. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses outside, 1-0 to start. The next pitch. Ball misses outside again. 2-0. Two balls, no strikes on the batter. One away, men on first and second. Here's the next pitch. That one misses outside again. 3-0. A walk here would certainly help the Eagles. It would put the bases loaded. Next pitch coming. Strike one called. Count goes to 3-1 now. On deck and waiting is Cam Carraher, the number 7 batter. And here comes the 3-1. Strike two called. Full count now, 3 balls, 2 strikes. Here's the next pitch. Ball 4 misses outside. And that'll walk Adam Magpak and send Cam Carraher to the plate with bases loaded and one away. You heard a little bit of chirping from the crowd and the Northeastern dugout there. It's a close borderline pitch. Bases loaded with one away. The first pitch to Carraher. Line drive. Base hit up the middle. Back into center field. One run is in. The runner at third is held up. And it'll be an RBI single for Carraher. And the Eagles get on the board here in the sixth, in the bottom of the fourth inning. Excuse me. And it'll bring up Parker Landwehr, the number 8 hitter. Jim is going to stay out there, it appears, for now. Base is still loaded with one away. And Jim will pitch out of the windup here. First pitch. Line drive. Will it stay fair? It will! Down the left field line, and it's going to hit up against the wall in foul territory. One run is in. Two runs are in. Throw is offline, and the third runner is in. Base is clearing. RBI double for Parker Landwehr, and that'll put the Eagles up 4-3 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. So the Eagles have responded well here And the head coach is going to come to pull his pitcher. But a bases clearing RBI double for Parker Landwehr here in the bottom of the fourth inning. And it'll put the Eagles on top for the first time today. Again, Northeastern had put up three earlier in the frame. Helped up by a solo shot from their eight-hitter Gregory Bazo, and the Eagles have now responded with RBI, with back-to-back RBI hits, a single from Cam Carraher, and now a bases-clearing RBI double from Parker Landwehr. So number 23, Charlie Walker, is going to come in for the Huskies here. As Gemma's day will end after 3 1/3 innings. But what a day that he had on the mound today. 8 strikeouts, 2 walks, but his day will now end with 4 earned runs. Plenty of baseball left to go here, but Eagles get on the board now for the first time in this inning. And they now take a 1-run lead in the bottom of the fourth inning. And we'll be back after a short break. Alrighty, we're back here now, still in the bottom of the fourth inning. One away with a man on second for the Eagles now after, again, a nice RBI bases clearing double from Parker Landwehr in the eighth spot. And now that'll bring up Sam McNulty, number 28, batting ninth. We'll see what he can't do against the new pitcher here as strike one called. Again, the new pitcher, number 23, Charlie Walker. He's a sophomore righty. 0-1 the count here. Swing and a miss by McNulty. 0-2 the count early. Again, still looking overcast on the field. Sun must be behind a couple of clouds. Minimal breeze, it appears. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses high, 1-2. Here's the next pitch. Foul down into the BC dugout, and it'll bounce back onto the playing field. Count will hold at 1-2. Here's the next pitch. Strike three called. Got him in the upper part of the zone there. So McNulty will strike out for the first time today. And that'll bring us back to the top of the order with Cameron Leary, who struck out back in the third and flied out in the first. Two outs now for the Eagles. Man on second still. Four runs already in the inning. Here's the first pitch to Leary. Ball misses high and out. The count to start. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses high. 2-0. Leary, as I said, looking for his first hit today. He's got a 2-0 count on him. Two away, man on second. BC now up 4-3 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Here's the next pitch. Strike one called. Two and one the count now. And the 2-1. Swing and a miss for strike two. Two balls, two strikes the count now. Second baseman again looking in that shallow right field position. Here's the next pitch. Line drive, and he's perfectly positioned to make a catch. And that'll end the fourth inning. So the Eagles get four runs in the bottom of the fourth to match Northeastern. They are now up by one run heading into the top of the fifth. And we'll be back after a short break. Time now for the top of the fifth inning. BC has switched pitchers again to number 38, junior Jordan Fiss, a right-hander. And the first man up here is number 10, the cleanup hitter Alex Lane, who has walked in both his at-bats. He takes strike one here. So let's see how Northeastern responds now that they are now down by a run. Swing and a miss for strike two. They're able to get a couple of big hits out of their players in the top of the fourth inning. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. 1-2 the count now. There's the 1-2. Popped up, close to first base. First baseman in foul territory makes the grab. And that's out number one.
Now batting for the Huskies, number five, Jack Goodman.
So they'll bring up the number five hitter, Jack Goodman, for his third time around to the plate. He is 0-for-2 today with a strikeout. One away here in the fifth inning, and a line drive right to the third baseman who makes a nice play. Shot a rocket down his way, but hit it right to him. So two away here early. And that'll bring up Gregory Bazo in the eight, in the eighth hitter here, the eight-hole hitter here. Or excuse me, Justin Bosland. Ball one here. Meant to say Justin Bosland, the six-hole hitter here. Next pitch, misses low. 2-0 the count now. Bosland is 1-for-2. He had a strikeout and a single, and he was the first runner to score on the wild pitch back in the fourth inning. Here's the next pitch. Line drive down. First baseman corrals off of him. Can he make the play? No. Could not get the ball in time. That'll most likely be scored an error. And it will be fielding error on the first baseman. So now man on first with two away here. First baseman couldn't field that ball cleanly, it looked like, off the one hop. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. But we've seen that happen to a couple of players now on this field. I don't know if it's... could be just the way that they're seeing the ball, or it could be something else, but that's the third ball I think that I've seen. Pickoff attempt isn't good. Runner gets back safe. That's the third ball, ground ball that I've seen today that was not fielded cleanly. Two by BC and one by Northeastern. 1-0 count to the hitter here. Pickoff attempt again. Safe at first. Should say we are now on the seven hitter, number nine, Harrison Feinberg. Ooh, runner took a heavy lead there. Hefty lead, I should say, but he gets back to first in time. Want to know the count still? Steal attempt, strike called. Is he able to get there? No. Throw was not in time. The runner gets a stolen base, but a strike call on the batter. So 1-1 now the count. Should say Feinberg is 0-for-2 so far. He has a strikeout and a foul out. Or a pop-up in foul territory, I guess I should say. And he went around on that pitch for strike two. That ball had missed in the dirt. But the home plate umpire ruled that he went around. One ball, two strikes. Two away with a man on second here. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. And the runner races back to second. Two balls, two strikes, the count here. Here's the 2-2. Line drive into center field. Can the center fielder make the play? He cannot. Is going to touch up against the wall. One run is going to be in, and the runner, Feinberg, is going to hold at second base with an RBI double. So Northeastern will tie them up here. And now Gregory Bazo will come up for the eighth spot. He hit a home run back in the fourth inning, and he is 2-for-2 today. Let's see if Fisk can't get himself out of here. The first pitch. Ground ball into foul territory. Down the third baseline. 0-1 to start out here. Again, if you're just joining the broadcast, Northeastern has just tied up Boston College here in the fifth inning, top of the fifth inning. Here's the next pitch. Popped him up. Third baseman calls for the ball, and he makes the catch in foul territory to end the inning. So we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Northeastern is able to get a run on the board. We are now tied at 4. BC coming up to bat. It's time now for the bottom of the fifth inning. Nick Wang is going to lead things off against Northeastern's pitcher Charlie Walker, coming back for his second frame. Wang is 0-for-2 with 2 strikeouts so far today. Here's the first pitch. Strike one down the middle. So 0-1 to start the count. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses outside. 1-1. Here's the next offering. Swing and a miss for strike two. Infield again. Both teams have been shifting pretty much for big parts of the day. You see another shift for Northeastern. Next pitch in the dirt for ball two. Three infielders on the left side of second base. First baseman about a third of the way between first and second on his side. Two balls, two strikes the count. The pitch fouled back into the netting. Count holds at 2-2. And here's the next pitch. Swing and a miss for strike three. Wang strikes out again. That's the second strikeout for Charlie Walker, the reliever for Northeastern. There's one away here now in the bottom of the fifth. And it'll bring up Vince Cimini, who's 1-for-2 on the day. Fouled off the first pitch. He was the one at the bottom of the fourth inning that got things started. It was the first run to come across on the RBI single by Cam Carraher. Swing and a miss again for strike two. Oh and two the count now. And here's the next pitch. Fouled away. Cimini stays alive. Peel down to the first baseman, or first base umpire. No swing. Ball one in the count. One ball, two strikes. One away here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Nobody on. The next pitch. Fouled away again. Here's the 1-2. Another foul ball. Cimini staying alive here. Again, he's 1-for-2 on the day with a run scored. Another 1-2 count. Ball misses low and out. Pitcher thought it was going to be strike three. Umpire ruled it was off the plate. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss for strike three. Cimini goes down on strikes for the second time today. That's the third strikeout for Charlie Walker of Northeastern. And that'll bring out the cleanup hitter, number 18, Kyle Wolf. So back-to-back strikeouts for Walker to start the fifth inning here. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses low, 1-0. Again, if you're just joining us, Northeastern has recently tied up the game at 4 apiece. They scored 3 in the top of the fourth. Ball misses outside that time, 2-0. They scored 3 in the top of the fourth inning, helped out by a home run by their 8-hitter, Gregory Bazo. BC came back and scored 4 in the bottom of the frame. And there's a fly ball into left field. Fielder going back on it at the warning track, and that ball is gone. Home run by the cleanup hitter, Kyle Wolf, and BC will retake the lead there. The left fielder looked like he lost it for a minute and just kept going back until he hit the wall, and it snuck right over the wall, right over the heart of left field, and BC will take a 5-4 lead. Patrick Roach will come up now here, the 5-hitter. It's a clutch home run there by Kyle Wolf. A needed one by BC. That ball misses high. 1-0 the count there to Roach. Swing and a miss there for strike one. But BC has answered every time Northeastern has scored so far. But in the bottom of the fourth inning, there was a bases-clearing double. Strike two called there. By the number eight hitter for BC as well, Parker Landwehr. So both eight-hole hitters have been doing good work for their teams. There's the 1-2. Ball misses low, 2-2. So two balls, two strikes, two outs, nobody on base. And then one apiece now has been scored. The batter did not go on the pitch. It missed low. That brings up a full count. Three balls, two strikes. Here's the payoff pitch. Grounded foul down the line. Count holds at 3-2. Again, the Eagles now up 5-4 in the bottom of the frame here, and there's a ground ball to the shortstop. Fielded cleanly, throws good. And they'll get him at first base. So that ends the fifth inning here. BC scores another run, or tacks on another run, I should say. They responded to Northeastern's top of the fifth score. And they hang on to a one-run lead going into the sixth inning. We'll be back. Alrighty, and as we hit the top of the sixth inning here, BC, as I said earlier, hanging on to a one-run lead. It is now 5-4. Jordan Fist still out there for the Eagles in his second inning of work. And we'll see now the nine-hole hitter, number 28, Carmelo Musacha, as he takes ball one here. Musacha 0-for-2 today with a strikeout. Here's the 1-0. Pitch misses high. Ball two. Here's the 2-0. Line drive into left field, and that's going to land for a base hit. Ball comes into second base quickly, and it'll hold to a single. So Musacha gets his first hit of the day, and the lineup will turn over back to Luke Beckstein, number 19. Beckstein is 0-for-2 with a hit by pitch today. Here's the first pitch. He showed bunt but pulled, and it'll be called a ball. One of the count here. Nobody out, man on first in the top of the sixth inning here. Pickoff attempt made. Runner gets back safely. Here's the 1-0. Shot down the line, and it's going to be fared on the left field. They're sending the runner from third to home. It's going to be an RBI double again. RBI double by Luke Beckstein. It'll retie the game. At 5 apiece now. So Tyler McGregor, the number 2 hitter, will come up with a man on second and nobody out here. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses outside. 1-0 the count here. Pickoff attempt made at second. Runner gets back safely. Here's the 1-0. Fouled into the netting. Two on the count now, sorry. Two balls, one strike. Nobody out, man on second. Here's the pitch. Strike 2 called. Two balls, 2 strikes the count now. Here's the 2-2. Ball misses high. Full count now. 3 balls, 2 strikes. I know they're going to switch the call now. It's 2 balls, 2 strikes, and a swing and a miss. It doesn't matter. First strikeout for Jordan Fiss on the day. So we were right the first time with the call. The scoreboard was off by a ball. But it turns out that it doesn't matter. It's a strikeout nonetheless. That'll bring out the cleanup hitter, Alex Lane. Strike 1's called. Excuse me, I was wrong. It'll bring up the number 3 hitter, number 8, Mike Sirota. So strike 1 to him. Sirota 1-for-2 on the day with a double. Here's the 0-1. Line drive into left field. That's going to be another base hit. They're going to send the runner. Cutoff man goes. Throw coming into home. Did he get him? No, he did not. Home plate umpire called him safe. For now, it stands as an RBI single. Let's see if BC wants a replay. And the umpire signaling time. The umpires will meet down by the mound. And they're going to review it. Review called by BC. They'll review the call down at home plate. It was a very close play. Left fielder got to that ball in a hurry and was able to get it in. Cutoff man made a nice throw to make it close. So either way, it'll go as a single for Mike Sirota. BC could use the break here. It's a tough play from up here, but the umpire made the call on the field that he was safe. So we'll see what they say. Looks like they're coming back pretty quickly here. As we await the call here. Home plate umpire coming out. And the call is upheld. The runner is safe. It'll be an RBI single. And Northeastern now takes a one-run lead, 6-5 here. And it will bring up the cleanup hitter, Alex Lane, now. The manager coming out to take the ball from Fiss. And BC will change pitchers. And we'll take a break here as they switch up their pitchers. You're listening to WZBC Sports. Now pitching for the Eagles, number 49, Michael Farinelli, the senior right-hander. And he'll come up against the right-handed batter, Alex Lang. He is 0-for-1 today with two walks. We'll see if Farinelli can't get out of the inning here. As a runner going early, and the catcher didn't make a throw. So a stolen base for Mike Sirota. Is ball one called there. 1-0 here. Runner now on second with one away. The next pitch. Ball misses in. 2-0. Here comes the next pitch. Swing and a miss for strike one. 2-1 the count now. Here's the next offering. Foul down the line, down the right field line. It'll go out of play. Two balls, two strikes the count now. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low, full count. Three balls, two strikes. One away, runner on second. The Huskies now up 6-5 on the Eagles. Put up two runs in the top of the sixth inning here that we're in. Here's the next pitch. Line drive out into left field. That ball is going and gone. Two-run shot for Alex Lang. And it'll put the Huskies up 8-5 here in the top of the sixth inning. So Lang getting his seventh home run of the year. So one away, base is cleared now. He throws ball one to the five-hole hitter, Jack Goodman. Next offering is low again, 2-0. Below the count, here's the next pitch. Strike one called. Two on the count now. Here's the next offering. Line drive out into left center field. That's going to be another base hit. Hits up against the wall. Center fielder gets it. Runner's going to hold up at second as it gets back into the infield. It'll be the first hit today for Jack Goodman, the number five hitter, as he doubles here in this sixth inning. And the batter's now number 21, Justin Bosland. He is 1-for-3 today with two stolen bases and a run scored. He singled and reached on an error, and the catcher, Parker Landwehr, now going out to talk to his pitcher. Trying to calm him down after the hectic antics of this sixth inning here. As Northeastern tries to pull away again. This is currently the largest lead that they've had today, a three-run lead that they've got going here. They had a three-run lead going into the bottom of the fourth inning, but they couldn't hold it. And now just as the catcher's meeting ends, it looks like the head coach will come out and he'll take the ball. And he'll pull on a new guy. So Farinelli's day is done after a few batters here in the sixth inning. And number 22, Charlie Kuhn, will come out for the Eagles. The senior southpaw this time. First left-handed pitcher to be brought up for the Eagles. Alrighty, as we get going back up here. Number 21, Justin Boslin coming up, the new pitcher again. Strike called. And called him out at third base on the attempted steal. And now the Northeastern coach wants a review of that play. As the runner from second tried to steal third base on the pitch. It'll be a strike call off the first pitch from Charlie Kuhn to Justin Boslin. And there'll be another review. About the fourth or fifth one today. So now as we await the call of the umpires, it'd be big if BC could get that out over at third base. It was called an out. So they have to see evidence in the replay that the runner's indisputably safe for it to be overturned. If the call stands, it'll be two away with nobody on and one strike to the batter, which would be huge in helping the Eagles get out of the inning. But if they overturn it and he's safe, the Eagles are in a little bit of a bind again. There's a runner now. There'd be a runner on third base with one away if that were to happen. Umpire's coming back out here onto the field. Let's see what the home plate umpire has to say. Signals. The out call stands. So the runner is caught stealing. So there's now two away with a strike onto the batter of Justin Boslin. So that means Jack Goodman was the one that was caught stealing. Swing and a miss for strike two. Here's the next pitch. It's a fly ball into left center field. Center fielder is making the catch. And that'll end the inning. So the Eagles get out of the sixth inning here, but Northeastern puts up four more runs behind a two-run homer by Alex Lang. And Northeastern's now back up 8-5 as we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. And we'll be right back to see if the Eagles can respond as they have the last two times. Thank you. As we head into the bottom of the sixth inning here, Northeastern has changed their pitchers. Now pitching for them, number six, Avon Cabral. He's a sophomore righty. And first up to bat for the Eagles is number two, Adam Magpak. He struck out in the second inning and walked in the fourth. Here's the first pitch, fouled away. Count starts at 0-1. So as I said before the break, the Eagles have responded both times that the Northeastern Huskies have put up runs. Let's see if they can't do it again. They're down three here. Here's the 0-1. Ball misses the corner, 1-1. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses outside, 2-1. The Eagles have been very patient in their at-bats here. It has hurt them a little bit, though, when Michael Gemma was the starter. He had 8 strikeouts off the Eagles, but they're showing patience here. And there's a slow tapper. Pitcher gets it, throws the first, and gets him for the out. One away here in the bottom of the sixth inning. And we'll bring up the 7-hole hitter, number 5, Cam Carraher. He is 1-for-1 today with a walk and an RBI single. He was the one that got the scoring started for the Eagles back in the bottom of the fourth as he takes ball one, low and out. And here's the 1-0. Ground ball fielded by the second baseman. Throws good. The umpire signals out. Second out of the inning. And that'll bring up Parker Landwehr, who had the big bases clearing RBI double back in the bottom of the fourth. He's the one that put the Eagles up originally in the bottom of the frame. Let's see if he can help the Eagles start a rally here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses low, 1-0. Here's the next pitch. Strike one called. And in that lower outside corner. 1-1 the count now. And here's the next offering. Ball misses low, 2-1. And here's the next pitch. It's a fly ball down the line. Three fielders looking to track. Can anyone get there? Left fielder gets there, and the umpire calls it an out. He made a sliding catch, and that'll end the inning. The Eagles go down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the sixth inning, and we will head to the top of the seventh inning. Huskies up 8-5. We'll be back after this. Here we go in the top of the seventh inning here. First up will be the number seven hitter, number nine, Harrison Feinberg. Charlie Kuhn still up for the Eagles, for pitching at least. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball into center field. Center fielder tracking, and he'll make the catch. One pitch, one out here in the top of the seventh inning. And here comes the number eight hitter, Gregory Bazo. He had the home run back in the top of the fourth. It helped get the scoring started for them. Strike one called here. Lights have started to come on here in the Harrington Athletic Village in Brighton. Here's the 0-1. Ground ball right to the shortstop. And he badly missed the throw. No, he did not. He got him for the out still. What I meant to say was he tripped on the throw. First baseman is able to corral it and keep his foot on the base long enough for the umpire to see it. And it'll go down as a 6-3. But it looks a lot tougher than that on film. So two outs here in the early going. And that'll bring up the number nine hitter here as he hits a line drive into center field. And it is going to land. Center fielder cuts it off from the wall. And the runner will walk into second base there. And he'll get a double. That was number 28, Carmelo Musasha. Now his back-to-back hits on the day. And the lineup will turn back over to their leadoff hitter, Luke Beckstein. He had an RBI double in the previous inning back in the sixth. Two away now, man on second base. And fires and misses low for ball one. 1-0 the count here. Pickoff made to second base. Runner gets back. There's the 1-0. Strike one called. Count moves to 1-1. There's the next pitch. Strike two called. One ball, two strikes. For the leadoff hitter, Luke Beckstein, who is 1-for-3 today with a hit by pitch and an RBI. Kuhn deals. That's grounded foul into the BC dugout. Count holds at 1-2. The next pitch. Ball misses high and out. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, the pitch. Fouled away behind the backstop. Still two balls, two strikes.
the next pitch. Popped up. Looks like it might stay in. First baseman going out, but it lands in foul territory. And we'll do it again. Fielders still getting back to their positions. It's a pretty long run for the first baseman there, but it was just out of his reach. And here's another 2-2. Ball hits the dirt. The count goes to full. Three balls, two strikes. Two away with a man on second. Northeastern up 8-5 in this top of the seventh inning. Here's the next pitch. Line drive smacked foul and out of play. The runner was stealing on that one, but he'll go back to second. And the count remains three balls, two strikes. Here's the payoff pitch. That's a ground ball right to the shortstop. Fires. Clean throw this time and a clean pick by the first baseman. And that'll end the seventh inning, or that'll take us to the bottom of the seventh inning here. As BC comes up to bat, they're down by three still. Northeastern up 8-5. And we'll see if BC can put some runs on the board and put this back in their favor. We'll be right back. Alrighty, as we get to the bottom of the seventh inning here, the first pitch is grounded out to the shortstop. And it'll be an out by Sam McNulty, number 28, the number 9 hitter. We've gone on 6-3 ground out here in the bottom of the seventh inning. And the lineup for BC will turn over again. Number 11, Cameron Leary, still looking for his first hit on the day. He is 0-3. They take strike one there from Avon Cabral. He had a scoreless bottom of the sixth inning last time out. That ball misses outside, 1-1 the count. One away here, nobody on. There's the 1-1. Swing and a miss for strike two. One, two, the count to Leary now. Here's the next pitch. And a line shot out of play. Count holds at 1-2. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Peels out. No call made, so it's a ball. 2-2 the count now to Leary. For any of you just joining us out there, Northeastern is now up 8-5. They put up 4 in the top of the 6th inning. We're in the bottom of the 7th now. As Leary fouls another one away, and the count holds a 2-2. Northeastern started off the scoring in the top of the 4th inning. They put up 3 runs behind a solo shot by their 8 hitter, Gregory Bazo. In the bottom of the 4th inning, BC responded. Their 8 hitter hitting a bases-clearing RBI double to put him up 4-3 in the frame. And there's a line shot into right field, and that's going to get down for a base hit. Leary going for second. The throw is cut off, and it's not going to be made to second. So Leary gets his first hit of the day and hits a one-out RBI and hits a one-out double. Excuse me. There was nobody on base when he hit it. So a man on base now for Nick Wang. We'll see if he can't make something happen here. He's 0-3 with 3 strikeouts right now. He could use a base hit here of any kind. One away, man on second. Strike one called. But as I was saying earlier in the recap, Northeastern then struck again in the top of the 5th inning, put up another run to tie the game on an RBI double. Eagles responded with a solo shot from their number 4 hitter, Kyle Wolf, for today. And Northeastern responded to that by putting up 4, and there's a pickoff attempt made at second, but Leary gets back in time. Northeastern put up 4 in the top of the 6th inning, supported by a 2-run shot by their cleanup hitter as well, Alex Lang. And here's the 0-1. Ball misses outside, 1-1. Let's see if BC can put some runs on the board and try to either tie it up or take the lead here. Here's the next pitch. Swing and a miss by Wang for strike 2. BC's offense has been held in check for most of the day. Their top 3 hitters all only have 2 hits combined. Ball misses outside. Northeastern wanted the call. The count moves to 2-2. Again, one away, man on second base. Huskies up by 3 in this bottom of the 7th inning. Here's the 2-2. Fouled away. Just managed to get a piece of it and keep it out of the catcher's glove there. Count holds a 2-2. Next offering, ground ball right to the shortstop. Throw is good, and Wang is out at first base. 2 away now in the inning. Leary held up at second base. So Vince Cimini comes up to bat, the number 3 hitter for BC. He is 1-3 today, excuse me. He has 2 strikeouts and a single with a run scored. He was the hitter that got things started off with a single back in the 4th inning. Pickoff attempt at second. Leary gets back safely. Let's see if Cimini can at least get a single here and give Leary a chance to score. There's a pitch. Fouled away. 0-1 to start the count here. next pitch. Swing and a miss for strike two. 0-2, the count now to Cimini. Here's the 0-2. Ball misses out. Count goes to one ball and two strikes. Again, two away here. Man on second in the bottom of the seventh for the Eagles. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses high and out. 2-2 the count now. Set and deals. Ground ball right to the shortstop again. Fires the first. Makes the play and gets the out. So we finish out the seventh inning. We head to the top of the eighth. Northeastern still up by 3. We'll be back after this break. Alrighty, as we get headed here into the top of the eighth inning now, Charlie Kuhn still on the mound for the Eagles for his third inning of work. Tyler McGregor up for the Huskies, and he grounds one down the first baseline. McGregor is 2-for-4 with an RBI double, a single, and a strikeout. Strike two called. 0-2 the count now. And here comes the next pitch. Ball misses low and out. 1-2 the count now. Here's the next pitch. Fly ball out in the left center field. Let's see if the left fielder can get there. He will not be able to. And it is going to hit off the wall. They'll give him a ground rule double. And it stays out of the park. So it's a ground rule double for Tyler McGregor. His third hit on the afternoon. And it'll bring up the number 3 hitter, number 8, Mike Sirota. He's 1-for-2 two for four on the day. Now for BC, Interdonado is going to come out and switch pitchers again. Charlie Kuhn's day is done after seeing one batter here in the eighth inning. BC now advancing onto their sixth pitcher today. They got a good start out of their starter. Evan Moore making his first start of the season. He went three innings, didn't give up a run, only gave up three hits, had four strikeouts to two walks on the afternoon. Of course, after that is when we start seeing the runs happen. The Eagles find themselves now down 8-5. New pitcher announced as number 15, Aiden Crowley, senior righty. He comes in inheriting one base runner and no outs here in the top of the eighth inning here. As we come back here, again, the number three hitter up for Northeastern, Mike Sirota. He was two for three, as I said, with an RBI, a double, and a stolen base. We have a man on second with nobody out. Ball on the dirt for ball one from Aiden Crowley, the new pitcher up for BC. 1-0 count to start off here. And here comes the next pitch. Fouled at the plate and behind the backstop. 1-1 the count now. Here's the next offering. Ball misses low, 2-1. Here comes the next pitch. Strike two on the inside part of the plate. Two balls, two strikes. Again, nobody out and a man on second base. The Eagles could use a stop here if they want to hold the deficit to three. They've got two innings left to try and make it up. Here's the 2-2. Ball misses inside. Full count now to the batter. Three balls, two strikes. Here's the next pitch. Fly ball into right field. Runner looks like he might tag from second. The out's made by the catch. Runner's going to tag, and he'll make it in time to third base. So essentially a sack fly for Mike Sirota. One away with a man on third now, and that'll bring up the cleanup hitter, excuse me, Alex Lang. Or Alex Lane, excuse me. His last at bat, he hit a two-run homer in the sixth inning. And there, it looks like they're going to intentionally walk him now as the umpire gives the signal that he can take first base. Well, on face, it doesn't look good. It's a nice strategic move, it seems. Puts a double play in effect now with runners on the corners and one away. So a ground ball to the shortstop or anywhere on the infield could turn two and get him out of this inning. That'll bring up the number five hitter, Jack Goodman. Goodman is 1-for-4 on the day. Here's the first pitch. Ball on the dirt. Catcher kept it in front of him. So 1-0 to start. Again, men on the corners with one away. Boston College made the decision to intentionally walk Alex Lane. And it is ruled a balk on the delayed steal. That'll score a run from third base. Second base umpire made the call for the balk. The runner from first had made a delayed steal attempt to try to throw off the pitcher's rhythm, and it looked like it was successful. So the Huskies get another run on the board as both runners advance on the balk call. Runner from third gets to go home, and the runner from first gets to keep his base at second. So the run will probably be charged to the previous pitcher, Charlie Kuhn, who allowed the runner to get on base. So one away now, runner on second base, and a 1-0 count. Here's the next pitch. First base umpire says he went around. It'll be a strike call. 1-1 the count now. So one ball, one strike. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low, 2-1. So BC now down by 4. Here in the back half of the game. 2-1 the count now. Next pitch. Low misses for ball 3. 3 balls, 1 strike the count now to the batter Jack Goodman. Again, Goodman 1-for-4 on the day today. He had a double and was caught stealing back in the sixth inning. Here's the next pitch. Line drive out into center field. Center fielder there, and he'll make the catch. Runner will hold at second base. So two away now with a man on second. Nice out for BC. And now number 21, Justin Boslin, the number 6 hitter, will come up. We'll see if Crawley can put him away. The first pitch. Ball misses high. 1-0 the starting count. Here's the 1-0. Foul down into the Northeastern dugout and out into foul territory in right field. 1-1 the count. Finally set, the next pitch. Ball misses high. Catcher had to pop out of his stance for that one. 2-1 the count. Again, two out, man on second. Northeastern find themselves up 9-5. Next pitch, fouled away again. 2-2 the count now. And here comes the next pitch. Swing and a miss for strike three. Got him down swinging. And that'll take us to the middle of the eighth inning. Northeastern picks up a run on the balk call from Aiden Crowley. And BC is going to have some work to do if they want to get back in this game. As we take a break here in the middle of the eighth inning, BC down by 4. Alrighty, time now for the bottom of the eighth inning here. First up to bat is number 18, Kyle Wolf. He hit a home run back in the fifth inning to put BC back on top momentarily. And there's a line drive, and that's going to be a base hit. On the first pitch, Kyle Wolf finds himself on first base. And BC gets a leadoff single here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Good start to what's going to need to be a rally for the Eagles here as they find themselves down 4, as I said earlier. That intentional balk back in the top of the inning gave Northeastern an extra run cushion. So here's the next pitch. Strike one called. Avon Cabral has put up 2 scoreless innings against the Eagles for Northeastern so far. He's looking for his third right now. But he finds a man on first with nobody out. Here's the 0-1. Nope. Pickoff attempt to first is unsuccessful. Here's the 0-1. Ball misses outside. 1-1. This is inside to Patrick Roche, the 5 hitter. 2-1 the count now. Roche currently is 0-3 on the day with a strikeout. Here's the 2-1. Fouled away into the netting. 2-2 the count. He and Nick Wang currently are the only hitters that have not reached base for the Eagles today.
Let's see if he can't buck that trend here.
The 2-2. Strike three called. First strikeout for Cabral on the day. It's the second strikeout for Roach. And up comes number two, Adam Magpak. So man on first, one away for the Eagles here in the bottom of the eighth inning. Here's the first pitch. Ground ball right to the second baseman. This could be two. Out at second. Get him at first, and the Northeastern Huskies turn a double play in the bottom of the eighth inning to put the Eagles away. We head to the ninth inning. Northeastern up by four. And we'll take a short break here as we head into the last inning of the game, or what could possibly be the last inning of the game. You're listening to WZBC Sports. We'll be back in a moment.
Alrighty, we head into the top of the ninth inning here. The Eagles have switched pitchers once more. Number 19, Brian McMonagle, the senior right-hander. He'll face off against the number 7 hitter for the Huskies, Harrison Feinberg, number 9. First pitch is called a ball upstairs. Feinberg is 1-for-4 today, with an RBI double and a strikeout. Next pitch, this is low, ball two. Here's the 2-0. Strike one called. Two on the count now to the batter. McMonagle set and deals. Swing and a miss brought him to his knees. Two balls, two strikes the count now to the leadoff batter in the top of the ninth inning. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. Full count, 3-2. Sun finally decided to come out, it looks like. Shadows covering most of the field at this point now, covering all of the infield except a little bit over third base. Here's the next pitch. Popped him up. We'll see if it stays in. It will not. It'll go out into the bleachers. Count holds at 3-2. A little bit of shadows down in right field, covering most of right center field as well. As we head into the
6 o'clock hour here in Brighton, Massachusetts. Here's the 3-2. Ground ball, third baseman coming into charge. Throws over. Nice play for the out. It'll be out number one, and it'll bring up the number eight hitter, Gregory Bazo. He's 2-for-4 today with a single and a home run. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses high. Here's the 1-0. Called, strike one. 1-1 the count now. One away here in the top of the ninth inning. Huskies up by 4. Here's the 1-1. Ball misses low, 2-1. Here's the 2-1. Ball misses inside. Just missed off the inside corner there. The count goes to 3-1. And here's the next pitch. Ball 4 missed high. That'll walk him. So they'll bring up the number 9 hitter, Carmelo Musacha. He's 2-for-4 on the day with a single and a double and a run scored. He was part of the rally in the 6th inning that put Northeastern on top and has kept them on top so far. Here's the pitch. Strike one called. 0-1 to start the count. Man on first, one away here in the bottom of the 9th inning. Here's the next pitch. Strike two called. Musacha looked like he wanted to swing at that one, but held up, and it was called a strike. 0-2 the count now. Here's the pitch. Grounded right to the third baseman. He fires from his knees to second. Throws the first. Not going to be in time. First baseman had to come off the bag. Try and make the catch, but they'll get the lead runner at second base. There's two gone now here in the top of the ninth. Third baseman made a nice throw off of his knees. Now the umpire's coming to talk to the second base umpire is going to talk to the pitcher about something. Or not the pitcher, the manager, excuse me. Vincent Donato's talking to the second base umpire. Might have had an issue with the slide at second base. It looked like there'd been some talking between either the shortstop or the second baseman and the runner, and it looks like now the umpires are going to get together and talk about it. And they'll go in and review the play. So I'm not entirely sure what they're reviewing out there. They might be reviewing whether or not the runner going to second base interfered by his slide. Or they could be reviewing the call at first base, but I don't think it's the call. I wouldn't think it's the call at first base, honestly. It looked like it was first baseman came pretty clearly off the bag and the runner had beaten him. So I'm guessing it had something to do with what happened over at second base. There were words exchanged between the runner and the infielder that was holding the bag. But nevertheless, the third baseman made a nice throw from his knees to at least get the runner at first, or second, I mean. if they do decide that there was interference on the play, the runner at first would be called out, and that would end the inning, which would be good for the Eagles here. But if the call stands and there was no interference, then there will be a runner on first with two outs. And we would see the Huskies go back to their top of their order. And number 19, Luke Beckstein, would be up. Quick review by the umpires. Looks like they're already coming back out of the dugout. Let's see what the home plate umpire has to say. So the runner at second is out, and no interference on the play. So with two away and a man on first, Luke Beckstein comes back up. He is 1-for-4 with a hit by pitch today. Pickoff attempt to first. Runner gets back safe. Here comes the first pitch. Ball misses low. Runner stealing again. Not in time, and the ball was dropped. So a stolen base by number 28, Musacha. And ball one to Beckstein. The 1-0. Strike one called. 1-1 the count to Beckstein. And here's the pitch. Ball misses low, 2-1. Again, two men on, a runner on second now after the stolen base. Eagles find themselves down by 4 here in the top of the ninth. Here's the 2-1. Strike two called. Two balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch. Ball misses low for a full count. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, and a man on second. Pickoff attempt towards second made. Runner gets back safely. Here's the payoff pitch with the runner going. Line drive hit out into left center field, and that's going to get down for another base hit. The runner from second will score. It's going to be an RBI double as Beckstein cruises into second base and calls for time. So Northeastern tacks another run onto their lead. They're now up 10-5. Here in the top of the ninth inning. And that'll bring up the two-hole hitter, Tyler McGregor. McGregor is 3-for-5 on the day with an RBI, two doubles, and a run scored. Here's the first pitch. Ball misses high. Want to know the count? McMonagle sets, and here's the next pitch. Strike one called. One and one the count now. Again, two outs. Another runner on second base. One run in for the Huskies in the top of the ninth. Here's the next pitch. Nearly hits him. But the umpire will call it a ball. Two balls, one strike here. Here's the 2-1. Ball misses low. Catcher's able to corral it. Keep it in front of him. And the count moves to 3-1. Kick and deal. Strike two called. Full count again. 3 balls, 2 strikes. 2 outs and another runner on second base. Here comes the payoff pitch. Ground ball charged by the second baseman. Fires the first and gets him. That'll finish off the top half of the ninth inning here. Eagles down to their last chance. They're down by 5. But they got one more inning to go. Let's see if they can't rally. We'll be back to the bottom of the ninth inning. Eagles down by 5. Alrighty, it's time now for the bottom half of the ninth inning. The Eagles' last chance to try and come back from a 5-run deficit now. And the leadoff hitter will be number 5, the 7-hole hitter, Cam Carraher. Carraher is 1-for-2 today with a walk. Let's see if he can't get us started here. Ivan Cabral, still in for the Huskies. He has pitched the last 3 innings with efficient work. Strike one called. Carraher showed bunt and pulled. So 0-1 to start here. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low. 1-1 the count here. The Eagles could use a few base runners here. Let's hope Carraher can get on to start us off. Here's the 1-1. Ground ball hit right to the first baseman, and he'll take it himself. One away here in the ninth inning. They'll bring up Parker Landwehr with 1 out and nobody on. Here's the first pitch. Strike one called. Landwehr is 1-for-3 today with a strikeout and a bases clearing double, or a 3 RBI double. He's the one that helped put the Eagles on the board in the fourth. Swing and a miss for strike two in the bottom of the fourth. Here's the 0-2. Ball misses low, skips in the dirt. 1 ball, 2 strikes the count. One away, nobody on. Here's the pitch. Ball misses low again. 2-2 the count. Here's the 2-2. There's a fly ball into deep left center field. Back at the wall. Did he make the catch? No, they're saying it's a home run. Home run by Parker Landwehr. The center fielder almost had a chance at that thing. Went right above his glove at the wall there. And so the Eagles get a run back on a home run. Solo shot by Parker Landwehr. That is his second home run of the season. And the Eagles are now down 10-6. So Sam McNulty will come up here in the ninth inning, one away. Is the nine-hole hitter before the lineup turns again. He shows bunt and takes a strike instead. Here's the 0-1. Fouled away. So the Eagles now only down four here after that solo shot by Landwehr. McNulty finds himself down 0-2. Ball misses outside. 1-2 the count. Landwehr shot a near dead center hit. Just a couple of feet off the batter's eye. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a miss for strike three. And McNulty goes down on strikes. Two away here in the ninth inning, and the lineup will turn it back over. Cameron Leary will bring things back. He's 1-for-4 with a double. That double actually being off Avan Cobral back in the seventh inning here. Ball misses outside for the first pitch. Leary will start off with a 1-0 count. Here's the next pitch. That one's called a strike. 1-1 the count. Two away here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Nobody on. Swing and a miss by Leary for strike two. The Eagles are down to their last strike. Here's the next pitch. Fouled back behind us in the booth here. Count remains 1-2. Here's another 1-2. Fouled away again. Leary fighting off pitches here. He's trying to stay alive. Infielder's playing pretty straight up. That second baseman out in shallow right field again, though. Here's another 1-2. Ball misses low and out. Two balls, two strikes. Eagles hanging on by a thread. Here's the 2-2. Fouled away. Count holds at 2-2. Here's the next pitch. Ball misses low and out. Full count to Leary. Can he hang on in this at bat? Three balls, two strikes. Here's the payoff pitch. Strike three called. Leary half swung at it, but the umpire called it a strike. And that'll end the game. Northeastern gets a win over the BC Eagles. 10-6, excuse me. So as we finish up here, with the final score being 10-6 Huskies over Eagles today, Northeastern will go to 13-5, an overall record, and BC will fall to 11-8. BC's next game will be, their next big set actually, will be this weekend at home against Virginia Tech. A valiant foe indeed. Virginia Tech having a winning record on the year as well. So we'll see the Eagles. We'll see if the Eagles can get a bounce back performance this coming weekend. As for Northeastern, they'll move on. 13-5. Players of the game for both teams for Northeastern. My player of the game would be Avon Cabral. Excuse me. He pitched 4 innings of 1-run ball for Northeastern to end the game. Kept BC from scoring again after they put up 5 in between the 4th and the 5th innings. And he's a good situational pitcher, as I was saying in the opener. BC needed situational pitching to get them through a game, and they were unable to get it today. Instead, Northeastern found situational pitching from one man, no less. He pitched 4 innings, had 2 strikeouts, and gave up an earned run on a solo shot by Parker Landwehr. For the Eagles, player of the game would probably be number 18, Kyle Wolf. He batted in the cleanup spot today, and he was 3-for-4 with 2 singles, a home run, and a run scored. 2 runs scored, actually. But we got a good start out of Evan Moore today. He went 3 innings, no earned runs, 3 hits given up, 2 walks, and 4 strikeouts. The starter for Northeastern also went about 3 1/3 innings, had 8 strikeouts to 2 walks, but gave up all 4 earned runs. So that'll do it for us here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us here on 90.3 WZBC YouTube, if you're watching on YouTube. And thank you for joining us wherever you may listen to this game. I'm Gregory Mihalik. Have a good night and enjoy the rest of your day.